Aloha, guys. From Maui. Excuse all the noises. I decided to do this outside on the porch, the balcony, whatever you call it. So you can hear the breeze and the trees, the dogs. Hopefully no sirens. But I just thought it might be nicer to do it outside than inside. So, I went to a place yesterday. I had a labyrinth. Actually, two. It's a bigger one and a smaller one. And they sold these little labyrinth things. I have two here to play with. So I'll do both of them for you. Pretty cool. Let's see, what was the place called? What does it say on the back? No. But see on the back of the first one here. It says the labyrinth is viewed as a metaphor for life's journey. It offers enlightenment as we walk the path. The labyrinth has a long history in Ireland, dating from the earliest Christian influences. The oldest known labyrinth found in Ireland is the Hollywood Stone, a boulder with a Cretan-style labyrinth carved into its face. The stone was found in 1908 and probably dates from circa 550 to 1400 AD. It's a big period. The stone was originally placed at the beginning of the long path to the Glendalough Monastery, founded by Saint Kevin in the 6th century AD. And I think that's this one. Pretty popular. But I saw this one and I wanted that. They had three different ones available, I think, at the store. So just going to trace it. Let's see how long that takes us. other ones. And if you'd like me to do these in a quieter setting, let me know, because I can do it again. Over and over, if you like. The traveling ASMRtist. It's my thing. So this one's more meant for your fingers. You know, you follow it with your finger. But that doesn't make much of a sound. Do it with the pointer. Oh, hi, Aunt. Lessons as we walk the path. Walking the labyrinth can assist us to address challenges, meditate, pray, and find peace and serenity. The labyrinth was
found in the Cathedral of Chartres.
I like that one. You can use your finger. Wow.